Nobody wants a slow computer. There's an off chance you're watching this video on a computer, but more than likely probably on your phone. Now, this may not always be up to you, as some computers just slow down with time due to the normal wear and tear of their parts, but there are plenty of ways to keep your computer running quickly regardless of how old it is. What is up, guys? Jimmy here. Welcome to the Late Night Top 10s, and today we are going to be going over for 10 easy ways that you can speed up your computer. Anybody can do these little tricks. Some of them you probably know, maybe one or two of them you don't, and it could help you get some better performance out of your computer in the long run. Before we get into it, we are running a $200 Amazon gift card giveaway the entire month of August. All you have to do to enter is like this video, be subscribed, turn on your notifications, and leave a comment why you want to win it with your Twitter handle attached. I will announce the winner at the end of the month on Twitter. Be sure to take advantage of the giveaway, be subscribed with your notifications on. That is the guarantee that you will get every video that I put up, specifically these Late Night Squad Midnight Top 10s. And now, let's see if we can speed up your computer at least just a little bit. Number 10, this one is probably the easiest thing and probably the most well-known, but it does help. Clear your cache and cookies from your web browser. If your computer is being a little slow while surfing the web, chances are your cookies and data are too full and they are slowing down your browser. Well, how can you fix this? Just get rid of the stuff that's slowing it down. It's simple. Just be gone stuff, I guess. Clear the cache, data, and the cookies from your browser, and you're likely to see a difference in speed since there is less strain on your actual internet browser. And since we're talking about browsers, okay, at number 9, I am not trying to get into a browser war, but in the comment section, let me know what your browser of choice is, and mine is Google Chrome. If you're not using Google Chrome on your desktop, you really should be, honestly. Chrome is vastly superior to all the other web browsers, not just in speed, but also in settings and accessibility. It's much easier to get into your web settings and see your cache, your data, your cookies, etc. with Chrome than it actually is with Safari, Firefox, or IE, or whatever it is you're using. If you're not using Chrome as your default browser, you should probably fix that, in my opinion, but be sure not to delete the other browsers on your computer just in case Chrome decides to crap out on you, because it's not perfect either, and I'm sure you guys are going to give me tons of comments of why it's not perfect. You don't want to be left without a web browser in the unlikely event that that ever happens, but to me, Chrome is definitely the choice to go with. At number 8, automate your updates. It's definitely easier to just hit the remind me later button when prompted with a software update. We all do it. I've done it. But if you don't want to update your stuff, those updates will just end up stacking up and making the process even more frustrating once you've decided to actually update. I want you guys to think about it. Would you rather update now for a few minutes or later for a few hours? Every time you click that remind me later button, you are making the process longer and longer, and you are just delaying the inevitable. Just automate your updates so you don't have to worry about it ever again. Plus, by keeping your software up to date, you keep your computer in top shape and reduce your likeliness of being hacked thanks to the updated software. And number 7, reinstalling your Windows. For the ultimate restart to your computer, and I don't suggest this unless you know what you're doing and you have a good backup and window image and all that good stuff, okay? There's actually a feature that will allow you to delete and reinstall Windows altogether. If you're just to the point where you want a fresh start, you can do this. If you go digging into your settings, the update and recovery section, you should see two options. Assuming you have Windows 8 or later, you should have the option to refresh your PC without affecting your files, or remove everything and reinstall Windows. Both of these will return Windows to its most clean, pure state, removing all the malware, viruses in the process that you may or may not have accumulated over time. However, if you choose to do this, you need to be aware that everything on your hard drive may be lost. So just be sure to save all your important files to a flash drive or an external hard drive before you hit that reset button, because you cannot undo that reset button. I have a big external that I do every Sunday. I do a Windows image backup onto just to be safe. And number 6, and this is a pretty easy one, turn off your animations. If you have one of the later versions of Windows, you're probably aware of the little animations that come with it. If your computer is strong enough, these animations are nice and make you feel cool at your desk. They're just all sleek and everything. But if your computer is older, these animations just serve to slow everything down. Your computer everything is a process. Your computer has to run every single thing that happens on it, no matter what. And a lot of behind the scene processes that you never even see. If you were to go to your task manager and click processes, you'd be probably a little bit shocked. If your computer falls into the second category of being a little old, do some digging in your settings so you can find the animations and you can actually turn them off. This should help increase your PC speed since it won't be putting extra work into something that is unnecessary. And for me, it's just rule of thumb. If I'm going to go stream or run OBS or some hog of a program, I go into my processes and I turn off everything that I know that I don't need going just so my computer has more power to focus on what I need. At number 5, get rid of the old programs. Don't be a pack rat. Let them go. Just about everyone has old programs on their computers they don't use anymore, be it old games, apps, web browsers, or those random installers you download in order to download certain things, specifically in gaming. There are tons of programs taking up space on your computer. Plus, there are all these programs that come preloaded on the computer that you actually never use. Go into your programs and look through to find these old downloads and get rid of the ones you know you're not going to use, that you know you never will use, and it will free up a ton of space, which is, it's almost like if your computer's a little on the heavy side, it's taking another notch out of the belt, letting it breathe a little bit. At number 4, deleting duplicate files. For whatever reason, a lot of computers feel the need to create duplicates of downloads, documents, photos, videos, you name it. I guess your computer just doesn't have faith that you won't lose anything, whatever the reason may be. These duplicates take up space. Go into your files, see if you have any duplicates and get rid of them. And now a lot of this stuff we're talking about is deleting. Make sure you're competent with what you are actually deleting. You don't want to go deleting core files or anything that the computer needs to run. So just be aware of what you're doing. But with that being said, there's a lot of wasted stuff on your computer that you can use and delete and streamline your computer's processing power. At number 3, speeding up the startup. When you turn on your computer for the first time of the day, how long does it actually take for it to turn on? Is it a few seconds? A few minutes? If the initial startup of your computer takes a long time, there may be some things you can actually do about it. Go into your settings and check out your startup settings to see what exactly is booting up when you hit that power button for the first time of the day. Most computers have a bunch of apps starting up along with the computer just to serve the slowdown process. Apps that you may not even need or even know that they're on there and you will never use. Check what apps are starting up with the initial powering of the computer and turn them off if they're not needed. This will make the startup of your computer way faster and put less strain on your machine. Now, if you want these apps, you can turn them back on if you want or use them once the computer's on, but you can turn it all off just so the computer can start up quicker. I mentioned earlier I have an external hard drive, and at number 2, that's exactly what we're going to talk about. Get you an external hard drive if you can. We've mentioned a lot of ways to clean up your hard drive in this video, but the best way that you can actually do this is just get a new hard drive altogether. External hard drives are incredibly helpful. You can get them in pretty much any size you could want, and they plug into your USB, and they're pretty much like massive flash drives, if you will. You can use them to store all your documents, your files, your videos, photos, and pretty much everything, thus reducing the strain on your computer's built-in hard drive and making things run faster because of it. I have an external where we keep all our pictures, documents, everything that doesn't need to be on the C drive of my main desktop. I definitely recommend looking into getting an external drive if your computer is running slow and your built-in hard drive is pretty full. Okay, the number one thing that I'm gonna give you, number one tip, is upgrade. This one isn't exactly something you can do with your current computer, but it still works 100% of the time. If you're struggling with a slow computer and you've done all you can to try and speed it up and nothing has worked, it may just be time to grab some new hardware. Maybe you need a new graphics card, or maybe you need to bump up your RAM, but whatever it is, you probably need to upgrade. That doesn't mean you have to throw the whole desktop tower, everything away. That is a common misconception that a lot of people make. Well, the computer's not working right, I have to dump it and go buy a brand new everything. That is not the case. You can buy what you actually need. If you're rocking some pretty old hardware like a graphics card, nothing seems to be speeding it up, maybe it's time to start shopping around Amazon and beefing up certain pieces of it to help it out. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 easy ways, easy things, easy tips that you can do to try and speed up your computer. It's a constant battle because new technology becomes old technology really, really fast. So hopefully some of this will help. And I will give one honorable mention, something that I use. It's a program called CC Cleaner, and I'll put a link in the description for it as well. You can actually get it for free. And I use it probably every other day. It cleans out all the old stuff. It's really user-friendly, and I've been using it for over a year now. So I'll put it in the description. You guys can check it out. And that's it. Hope you guys have a great day. There's a playlist below with all the other late night top 10s that go down. There's also a link if you guys want to submit ideas for future late night top 10s. Hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you tomorrow night.